Okay, so this is a, we will have a look at problem number 60. This is a very famous and well-known problem in geometry, which is how to divide a given segment, any given segment, into an equal number of smaller segments. So, if I give you a segment which is say 15 centimeters long and I say divide it into 20 equal parts, how do you do it? But the problem is that you cannot use a scale. That means you cannot measure anything. You can only use a compass and a ruler to draw a straight line. This is a very well-known problem in geometry, and that is why I'm making a little video about it. So, and also, three of you didn't do it, and of the two who did it, only one gave the proper explanations. So, we will have a look at it. I will explain to you step by step how to solve this problem, and then in general how to solve any problem where you have to divide a given segment into a given number of equal parts. So now I have drawn it here. So what I have done is, don't get confused by the number of lines. First, this is our AB, which par hypothèse, here I said 2 cm. Okay, that says there 2 cm. So I've drawn this as 2 cm. Then I've drawn a line which goes out at an angle AX, in the midroat AX, AX, and I can draw it at any convenient angle for me. I could have drawn it like that, I could have drawn it here, so I just chose to draw it at this angle because it seemed convenient to me. Then, because I am asked to divide AB into 7 equal parts, I mark out 7 equal parts on this. But what do you mean by 7 equal parts? What do I mean by that? It just means that I take a random distance. Here I took this distance AC, I used a compass, I marked it, then I moved the compass point here, marked it here, then I moved it here, then I moved it here, and so I marked 7 equal segments on this. The length of these segments is not important as long as they're equal. So you can set your compass to any width and you can just mark it out. Of course, if I had taken a compass of this width, I wouldn't have been able to get 7 equal segments on my paper. So obviously you take something which is reasonable. Neither do you take something very small. If I had taken something which is just a few millimeters, then I would get all 7 segments within that distance. It wouldn't have worked. This is the right thing. That's why you see these little curves here to mark that I've used a compass to mark out an equal distance for each point. And again, I reiterate that this distance can be anything I like. I don't even need to measure it on a scale. Actually, we don't even have a scale for this problem. We just have a ruler. In English, in American English, it's called a straight edge, meaning it's a scale without any markings on it. It is only used for drawing a straight line, rather for measuring. Scale is the thing like this, which has markings on it, which has distances marked on it. Okay. So if I used it, if I use this ruler upside down like this, then it'll become a ruler, a straight edge, because there are no distances marked on it. Anyway, so this is the thing first I do. So I mark 7 equal segments of any length on this, the midroat AX. Then on from the last point, I've called it F, I join it to my point B. So I am now forming a triangle AFB. Okay. Then I've called this point C. I've just named it arbitrarily C. I draw a line which is parallel to EB. So now what do we have? We have basically I'll draw it in small here so that we don't get confused by the other lines. We have basically configuration de Thales like this: A, C, F, and this I called D, and this is B. This is what I have here: A, D, C, A, D, C, A, B, F, A, B, F. A, ici on a C, D. Droite CD parallel à droite FB. So once I completed this triangle, from point C I drew a line that is parallel to line FB. Once I have this, then obviously par theorem de Thales on peut dire AC sur AF est égal à AD sur AB. You can pause the video at this point and see. AC sur AF est égal à AD sur AB. Correct? Okay. Now we know that AC is 1/7 of AD. On sait, par hypothèse, AC sur AF est égal à 1 sur 7. Because we took these as 7 equal parts. If this was 1 centimeter and this is 7 centimeters, then AC sur AF est égal à 1 sur 7. Donc, AD sur AB est égal à 1 sur 7, which means that AD is 1/7 of AB. So you have actually divided it into 1/7. Now, if we draw another parallel line from this point, you'll get 2/7. 3/7, 4/7, 5/7, 6/7, and 7/7, which is 1. So you get 7 equal parts. So basically you got a segment of any length and you divided it into 7 equal parts, because in this problem they asked for 7, they could have asked for 10, they could have asked for 3, they could even have asked for 2. And we could have done it in this way. So, and we haven't used a scale at all. We haven't used this part of the scale. We haven't done any measurement at all. All we have used is a compass to mark this out. Tuck, tuck, tuck. And then we have drawn parallel lines. But some of you might be asking, hey, yes, Kimda, but how did you draw that parallel line, say they? How did you draw say they parallel to FB without any measurements? Now that's a very simple and mathematical problem. That is, if I have a line like this and I have a point here, how do I draw a line which passes through this point which is parallel to this? This is actually what we have up there. So we have a line which in our case is FB. We have a point which in our case is C. I could even redraw it here, F, B, and C. So how to draw CD so that it is parallel to, how to draw CD so that it is parallel to FB? Excuse me. So the simplest way to do that is to complete a parallelogram. And that is what I have done here. I have taken F, B, let's call this point Z. So my F, B, Z, C, F, B, Z, C is a parallelogram. Okay, now how do I draw a parallelogram? Well, a parallelogram has one very simple property, that the opposite sides are equal in length. So what I did was I took my compass and I have marked, I measured FB, correct? FB, sorry, my finger is coming in front of the lens. I marked out FB, I moved it here, and I drew a curve here. You can actually see that curve here. I drew a curve here. Similarly, I took FC on with a compass, and then I shifted it to B here, the point B, and I drew a curve here. Where it cuts is point Z. So that means BZ is equal to FC and CZ is equal to FB. So this is the simplest way of drawing a parallel line from C, drawing a line from C that is parallel to FB. So I just completed this. So with a compass and a straight edge, I have divided this segment into 7 parts. Now I could also have done, for example, let me turn the page to a blank page, and I could have said, a problem could have been that we have this segment and divide it into 6 equal, or let's say for simplicity's sake, 3 equal parts. So what I could do is, first of all, I draw a line from here which goes in actually any direction as long as it doesn't go in the same direction as AB. So, but it shouldn't be too close because then my drawing will not be very accurate. So let's say I can even draw it going like this. My X is here. Okay. Then I mark out 3. Now I'm doing this without a compass, but approximately. So I mark out 3 equal points on this. This is equal to this is equal to this. Okay. Then I join this point with B. Then I draw a line parallel. Again, I've shown you how to do that. That is parallel to this line. Let's call this point D. So from C, I draw a line that is parallel. Let's call this E. Similarly, from point K, I draw a line that is parallel to these two, which is L. And now what we have? We have AL is equal to LE is equal to EB. This is the way you have to do it. I've drawn this line this way. I could have drawn it in this direction, just like I did on the previous page. I could even have drawn it like that. I could have drawn it like that and done it. So here also, if I've taken this line, let's say I've taken this line and I've used really big sections. I'm again doing this by eye. So let's say this is equal to this, then I join these two points, then I draw a line parallel. Yeah, it should actually come there. And then I draw a line parallel, and again you will come to the same points. Okay, so this is the explanation of problem number 60, the first part of it in any case. And similarly, the second part said, tracez un segment de longueur 11 cm et partagez un 6 segment de même longueur. So again, you would do the same thing. You would draw the line segment 11 cm. Here you would take 6 segments and draw parallel lines. This is the well-known way of dividing a segment into equal parts without doing any measurement. I will stop here. I will not give you any assignment for today, but please let me know just by sending me a text that you have actually watched the video. That way I will know that you have. I stop here.